Hi, my name is Mike Gaben and welcome to my KSP campaign. I'm just here doing a bit of time warping and wait for it. Ha ha! That is now my research and development center fully upgraded. It took a bit of effort, it was a lot of money and a long time coming, but it was well worth it because that completely unlocks the tech tree. Well, not unlocks it. Of course, I still have to raise the science to start unlocking nodes, but all those nodes are now available to me. Boy, we'd best get some sciencing done, I suppose. So let's get right into a mission. This is the Kegel 3, the third in a series of crewed landers that I have built. And this one is on its way to Minmus, where it is going to be rendezvousing with Minmus Station. And, ooh, wait, let's take a moment to admire my new updated research and development center. Anyway, a little distracted there. Why don't we get back to the Kegel 3? So, the primary mission is going to be to fulfill a contract to rescue Gilly Kerman from the surface of Minmus. Well, Gilly and her scrap. She is also down there with what I believe is a Mark II cockpit. And I gotta get the Mark II cockpit off of the surface of Minmus and back and recover it on the surface of Kerbin to fulfill all the requirements of the contract. So obviously this lander is not gonna be my standard type of lander because it's got to sort of accomplish that. And I'll get to the design in just a little bit. Anyway, once it gets to Minmus Station, we're going to be crewing it from, only one member from the crew of the Kerion 2, which is currently also in an adventure around Minmus, specifically dealing with actually the original Kegel. And we'll be getting to that very, very shortly. We'll also be getting to the Kerion 1. The Kerion 1 is in orbit around the moon, doing, well, lots of temperature scans. It's been spending the last couple of episodes doing temperature scans, not quite knowing when they're going to end. And hopefully we'll be getting back to them and hopefully they will be finishing off their mission and perhaps thinking about getting themselves back to Kerbin. But why don't we keep talking about the Kegel 3 here? My last Kegel, the Kegel 2, which is currently in orbit about the moon, and you saw landing on the moon a few episodes ago. That was a 5-person lander. This guy's just back to a normal 2-person lander. And you can see that it is equipped with science and stuff, because of course I am going to take advantage of being on the surface of Minmus and collect some science while I'm there. But again, the primary mission is going to be to recover Gilly and to recover her scrap. And in order to recover her scrap, I have to somehow connect onto it. Now I could have used that claw that comes with the stock claw that you use to hook things up, and I've used it to hook the asteroids, but I really don't like it to hook spaceships together. I think I've mentioned that before. So instead what I'm going to be using is, well, a bunch of KAS parts here. You can see I've got some KAS struts in there. I also have a KAS pair of pipe endpoints. The struts won't go between two different vessels, so you first have to make the two vessels into one vessel, and for that I need the pipes, even though I don't plan on transferring any resources back and forth. I'll get back to the Kegel in just a second, but I just want to show you what I got here. I got some air brakes now on my lifters. I found when I was getting up to these 2.5 meter lifters, they were getting too heavy when they were coming in, and parachutes were having some issues slowing them down for recovery. So I put some air brakes on it to help sort of slow it down as it re-enters into the atmosphere. You might recall that what I do is I like to detach these lifters when my periapsis gets around 50 kilometers. That's too high for when it's not being rendered for KSP to consider it in the atmosphere, and I'll stay in orbit indefinitely. But then when I'm ready to recover it, what I just do is I go to it, it gets rendered, atmospheric physics takes over, and then it makes its way back down to the surface and I recover it. To be quite honest, I don't know, I'm starting to find that getting to be more and more a pain with me having more and more launches. I might just start doing things like dropping it well before periapsis is at 50 kilometers, or perhaps even just slapping a probe body on this thing and a bit of electricity so that I could turn it around and just do a deorbit burn and then just let stage recovery take care of recovering the parts. to be honest, I'm not recovering that much cash to really make it. I'm starting to question whether it's really worth my time to go through all that effort. Anyway, back to the Kegel. You can see here that I got absolutely nothing on the bottom of that main fuel tank. I wanted to keep that clear. Remember that I need to recover a Mark II cockpit from the surface of Minmus. So my plan here is that it will fit underneath here. I've made the landing gear. I made sure, hopefully, that the landing gear will allow this to land and sit above a Mark II cockpit. And then I'm going to sling it underneath, again, using those KAS parts. And hopefully be able to lift it off, get it back to Minmus Station. Back at Minmus Station, we can fit it with a docking port and all that kind of stuff. And then the Kerion 2 can haul it back towards Kerbin, and then we'll worry about how I'm going to get it back down to Kerbin surface. I don't know, sometime in the future. Maybe I'll get it into a shuttle. I don't know. We'll do it. It's not that big. It shouldn't be too hard. Anyway, all of this sort of KAS work, though, necessitates an engineer. So that pretty much locks down who's going to be flying this thing. It's going to be Glafia. Glafia is my engineer aboard the Kerion 2, and she is out there right now. And so she's going to be taking this thing down solo. Remember, it is just a two-person lander. And the other space, of course, is going to be for Gilly to get her back. Anyway, right now you can see that the Kegel is in the midst of its injection burn to get it over towards Minmus. It won't be getting to Minmus for another game week or so. So that's not going to be happening in this episode, but obviously will be happening in a very near future episode. In the meantime, well, I got me some science to get. This is the Model K2, which you actually have seen before. You saw it several episodes ago. I was using it to demonstrate the Surface Science Pack. This is a mod that gives a variety of surface science parts. That you use, you can attach them to the surface, you bring them with you, the very small parts, and you can do additional science with you through EVAs with your Kerbals. It requires the use of an engineer, it obviously requires the use of science. Very fun pack, but it is a lot of work to set up. And it was after completing that mission that I sat there and I wondered, can you stick the science parts to the outside of a vehicle? Well, as you can see here, it turns out that you can. And so I'm going to be going around the Kerbal Space Center, grabbing science from all of these little microbiomes that are all over the place. Here I am at the administrative building. And of course, once I'm done doing that, Bob's going to go out there and collect it. And I'll be the first to admit, this certainly doesn't look good. It's a little bit awkward for Bob to get around to the various science gizmos that he needs to get around to. I didn't think about this until after this thing was already in the process of being built. So I had to use Krisnik to grab all the parts out of that storage container and start sticking them on. So obviously there was no no foresight this at all, especially when it comes to getting these back science parts here. This turned out to be a little tricky, but well, it turned out there's a nice little platform here that Bob can get to that, yeah, he can reach all this stuff from here. I think if I were to do this again, if I build special platforms just for the surface science gear so that Bob has an easier time getting around. And this does look, oh, it's a little junky, but heck, if anything looks like a science mobile, it's this thing, that's for sure. And by the way, the main reason I'm doing this now, why this got motivated to do right now, is because, come on, Bob, you can get through there. Gotta try harder. There he goes. Okay. The main reason I'm doing this now is because of the upgrade to the Research and Development Center. Not just because I need the science, but also because that opens up a whole series of other mini biomes. Remember, other than just the main areas of the Kerbal Space Center, there are little biomes hidden within those. And some of those start to come up as you upgrade the buildings. And in fact, 7 additional mini biomes got opened up because of the upgrading of the Research and Development Center. Right now, I am at the R&D Small Lab. But there is also the R&D Central Building, the Side Lab, the Observatory, the R&D tanks, the wind tunnel, and the R&D Corner Lab that are now available to me. And all of those are independent little biomes. You can collect all the science that you want there. It gives me a nice opportunity as well, an excuse to do a nice little tour of the Research and Development Center, which obviously I'm enjoying here. Clearly, this does take a fair bit of time, and I do plan on revisiting a lot of the old biomes too with this science tech, including some of the nearby biomes like the shores and the grasslands and stuff like that, but I'm not going to be showing all that to you. Obviously, that gets pretty repetitive, and so here, we'll cut to, I'm just gotten the science from the R&D tanks, and that actually leaves just the wind tunnels and the corner lab left, and after that, I'll continue to make my way around to the other biomes around the KSC. Ooh! Uh-oh. Uh-oh, I think I just broke a wheel. Stop. Yeah. I just broke my left front wheel there. Oh, well done. And I think... Ooh, Krisnik is just a level one engineer. I don't think that's going to be good enough. Okay, let's see here. Okay, repair wheel. Insufficient experience. Yep, level 3 required. Oh, don't fall down. Okay, so we cannot fix the wheel. We can do lots of things with our engineer, but we can't fix the wheel. Come on, you can get up there. There he goes. Nicely done, Krisnik. Okay, well, actually, I was able to hobble this thing over to the remaining two mini biomes that are in the Research and Development Center just to finish that off. And then I ended up cutting this mission short. But even with the mission aborted, that was 524 science, which allowed me to unlock my first Tier 8 science node, and I did not hesitate with this for a moment. This was going to be advanced science. I've been eyeing this for a while. The gravioli detector, that is going to be quite the science sponge for me. And the beginning of the drilling and refining equipment for starting to do some space harvesting. I've been looking forward to both of these for quite some time. And it won't take long to rebuild the K2. I'll reposition the science a little bit better as well, so it's easier to get to. But right now, let's get ourselves out to the Kerion 2, which is just about set to perform its burn and set up its rendezvous with the original Kegel 1. Yeah, as you can see, the exhaust animation on those Nerva engines is still not working right. I don't know. I don't know what to do about it. It still all works, so I've decided more or less just to kind of live with it. Everything still works just fine, so it's just an aesthetic thing, I suppose. Still a little bit annoying. Okay, let's see here. Let's finish this off. I'm not thrusting. Okay, I'm pushing the shift key, but it's not thrusting. Let's open up the nav ball. Now let's do it. Okay, why do I have to have the nav ball? Oh, well, whatever. I don't care. All right, it's pretty close. We'll finish this off with RCS. Okay, looks pretty good. What we got? 0.4 kilometers and 1 hour and 23 minutes. Awesome. So we'll set ourselves up an alarm for that using Kerbal Alarm Clock. Wake us up as we approach the Kegel. But I got a bit of an experiment that I want to do first. I've been thinking about science in the laboratory module. I want to do a crew report. I want to do a crew report right here. And note 22. Yes, I could research 22 science data points, even though I've done crew reports in space near Minmus before. So here, let's EVA out Chrissy. She's our scientist. We'll do an EVA report. Okay, I don't see anything there. I am over Minmus's poles. But what I'll do, I'll collect that. And let's get back inside. This is a science module here at the front that comes from Homegrown Rockets. And now let's review our stored data. There, you can see that? I can research that. Even though there's no science to get, I can still, okay, that's the EVA report over the poles. Let's get that going first. Okay, so that crew report has been researched. That added science data points to my lab module. So we'll get rid of that. I don't need that anymore. And the EVA report that Chrissy just did, that's, oh, it says there's not enough room. Okay, oh, I don't know if I should have trashed that. Oops, shoot. Okay, let's take a look at the lab module. Yeah, it says that I have 360 data out of 400. So I guess this thing is getting too full. And I don't have... Okay, let's get Chrissy out there. We'll do another EVA report and get that EVA report over the poles back. But I guess this lab module is full and I don't have any more scientists. Even though I do have another lab module, but I can't research it. But what I'll do is I'll collect this science anyway, because I'm pretty sure what I can do is take the science back to Kerion Station. I have a lab module that is in the building queue that's going to be attached to the station, and then I can get some research happening there. Man, yeah, that this is going to turn into quite a bit of science data, I guess that's the term for it. Science data that I can generate and get researching. So I think the thing to do is I want to get lab modules maybe kind of going all over the place and start collecting, even though I've gotten the science before, start generating that data so that it'll generate even more science. So I'm going to have to take EVA reports over all of the biomes. So let's get this... okay, let's turn it to a biome map. I should be getting a biome map now. And oh, wait, I'm on the moon. Turn this to Minmus. There we go. Ooh, that looks really crappy. And oh wait, Kerbal Engineer is telling me I am over the lowlands. Let's get Chrissy out and do... Ah, she's behind the map. Can I get her? There you go. Oh, I can't get the button. Okay, gotta move the map. Get out of the way. Okay, EVA report. That one. There we go. Okay, that's over the lowlands. Grab that. And the map looks really crappy because I have the resource overlay on. Okay, let's get Chrissy back inside here. Yeah, no, let's get this biome map going. I was sort of waiting to see if it would change to another biome, but I really can't see anything. So resources, how do I turn that off? No, it's not in that. Oh wait, there's a toggle down here. There we go, turn that off. There we go, now I'm getting myself a nice biome map. You see, it's not quite complete yet. My mapping satellite is still working hard. I'll have to remember to get out there and get the science from that as well. Oh, that's another biome. EVA report over the Midlands, great. And what we'll do is I'll use this biome map to sort of see what biomes are coming up. We'll grab EVA reports over all of those. Unfortunately, the Kerion 2 is not equipped with science. It doesn't have any science parts on it. That's too bad. You know what does have science? The Kerion 1, which is in orbit about the moon, it has all the science parts on it. So I have to remember to collect science data. Remember, I'm not really getting the science points, just the data points from the Kerion 1 as well. I mean, it doesn't generate a ton of science. Right now, this lab module, which is almost full of data, is generating 0.22 science per day. It's not huge, but, you know, it's there. I might as well grab it all, and if you add it all up, now right now it only has one scientist in it too. If I get another scientist into the mix, the rate will increase. And oh, and by the way, I was speculating a few episodes ago, if I move the science lab around into different spheres of influence, does that affect the rate at which science is generating? And the answer to that question is actually no. It seems that the rate at which you're generating science is a function of the amount of science data points you have and the level and number of scientists that you got. Ooh, I'm going to have to start leveling up scientists to make this work. That, I now am up to 396 science and generating 0.24 science per day. Okay, I guess that's not so bad. You know, you multiply that over a lot of lab modules, a lot of scientists, and it's happening passively. It's not like you're doing too much. I think it'll be worth my time. But anyway, I'm not going to show you all of this science scrounging, of course. What I'm going to be doing instead is I'm going to be cutting over here to our rendezvous with the Kegel 1, which we're going to scuttle. We're going to get rid of this thing. And wait a second. Hang on. Ooh, I was just bemoaning the lack of science on the Kerion 2. But this lander's all equipped. It's got science on it. Oh, I think we got us some appropriation to do. Okay, we're going to have to start off by bringing our relative velocity down to close to zero. So let's do that first. 0.1 meters per second. I'm going to use a little bit of RCS. I certainly do not want the Kerion drifting into the lander here. And we'll spin this around. I don't know, just for the aesthetic part of it, I suppose. We'll point the Kerion at the Kegel. And thankfully, aboard the Kerion, we have the Queen of Appropriation. I think someone who has stolen more parts from more vessels, and that's going to be Glafia. Oh, she loves doing this. This is their favorite thing to do, is going around ripping off parts from other vessels. So we'll send her out there with her trusty electric screwdriver. We'll also attach some explosives, because we are going to scuttle this thing and get rid of it. But first, we're going to get off of it what we need. And I will point out that this is not piracy. You know, all of this is all owned by the Kerbal Space Center, so we're just borrowing. Oh, borrowing? No, we're not borrowing. Okay, maybe it is piracy. Whatever, doesn't matter. Who's going to stop us now? Okay, so we can't grab the whole science package. It's got way too many parts to it. So we'll start taking these individual science parts. So there we go, got the thermometer. And there's a barometer there, and there's also a seismic sensor. We might as well grab that too, even though I'm not sure what we would use it for. And of course, a mystery goo. And then we're going to have to start taking all of these parts off of here, and I'm just going to stick them all to the Kerion. Oh, this is going to look pretty ugly when we're all done, but I really don't care. Okay, so the last piece attached to the material space is this little ladder piece, and we'll just... I'll stick this down here. There we go. And now let's drag that over to Glafia's inventory. And oh, it's way too big. I am over by over 1,500 liters, and Glafia can only carry 300 liters personally of inventory. So she has nowhere near the space to carry this thing. And I don't have one of them there KAS storage containers that I can use as a backpack. So we're going to have to come up with a solution. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to nose in the Kerion here. Try and get in really close so that Glafia can remove the materials bay and bring it over to the Kerion in just sort of one motion, and not have to carry it. And I'm doing this at 4x speed because obviously I did this pretty cautiously. And unfortunately, the Kegel does have, or did have, a docking port. I've ripped it off, but the docking ports were of different sizes, so that wasn't going to really help. Oh shoot, the hatch is in the way. I'm going to have to rotate around the other way to give Glafia a clean surface to shoot for attaching this. This is looking pretty good. Yeah, I think we're going to go for it. Okay, Glafia, let's do this thing. So, equip her screwdriver, kind of try and position her so she's sort of midway between those two. I'm not 100% sure actually the materials bay will fit there. Let's put it. Oh, it's green. And there we go. That'll do it. It ain't pretty. That's for sure. And probably it'll just be temporary as well until we get this science scrounging done. But I think this will do. And I think the time has come for us to bid farewell to the original Kegel. And it's not going to be Glafia who's going to set up the explosives. She attached them to the Kegel, but I think that honor really should go to Chrissy. Yeah, it turns out that the original pilot of the Kegel is here aboard on this particular mission, just by coincidence. So Chrissy, way back, was the first Kerbal to walk on an alien world to land on the moon, so she has some very fond memories of this thing, mostly of hitting the ground at over 100 kilometers an hour. You might think that that might not be a good memory, but let's face it, if you crash your car into a wall at over 100 kilometers per hour and walked away from it, you'd be pretty grateful to the car. So I think Chrissy will go inside here, take one last look from inside. Let's rotate this. and we need to make this more dignified. We'll point it in a northward direction so that it looks upright, you know, and standing tall, standing proud as we say goodbye. There we go. And in fact, let's go inside here and we'll roll, take a look at the Kerion. Chrissy gets one last view from inside the cockpit. There's Minmus. There we are. Ooh, going back. We'll turn off the UI so that we have a nice view. But then I think it's time for us to do the deed. Goodbye, Kegel. It's been fun. Boom. Unfortunately, I lost the sound there. I don't know why. But anyway, we got to get Chrissy back aboard the Kerion too, and then we're going to get the crew back to Minmus Station to await the arrival of the new Kegel 3. But I think we're going to be finishing off with the Kerion 1 in orbit about the moon. Now over 12 days into its mission, the vast majority of which was spent collecting temperature scans. It seemed every time I, well, it wasn't a scene. Every time I collected a temperature scan, another one would spawn. I was never knowing when this mission was going to be completed. So we're now doing our fifth scan, coming up to our waypoint. Okay, we're here. All right, temperature scan. And oh my gosh. Oh, there isn't another one. Contract complete. Oh, finally. Thank you. Oh my goodness. All right, that's it. But before we get set to send these folks back home to Kerbin, well, you know, there's this other Kerbal. His name is Willman, and he's stuck in orbit about the moon, and I was contemplating perhaps picking him up on the way out of here. The thing is, I'm not quite sure I have the Delta V to get there. You see, here, we'll take a look here. There's the Kerion, and there's Willman. Can I get there? I'm not really sure, but we're going to find out. But it's going to have to be next episode. I thank you for watching, and I hope to see you next time.